Hi, this is Karen Davis of House of Stitches podcast. I go by the name of Carota, so feel free to call me Carota. If you are a returning viewer, yay! I'm happy that you've returned. You know, there's so many podcasts out there, and for you to spend 30, 45 minutes of your time with me, I appreciate it. I do. If you're anything like me, though, I watch podcasts more than I listen to radio or watch TV. I just kind of put it on either when I'm knitting or crocheting or just kind of in the my basement studio space, piddling around. I have them on. And then I also watch them sometime when I'm a couple of them right before I've fallen asleep while in bed. So, but they're always on. So if you're anything like me, you are always watching them and enjoy them. So again, thank you if you are a returning viewer. If you're a new viewer, like I said, my name is Karen. I'm sitting in my dining room. And I think this is going to be my permanent space too. I think the lighting seems to be better. I record on a tablet, which seems to be the best so far. I've used various different things. But anyway, I go by the name of Carota, so feel free to call me Carota. I can be found on Instagram as Studio Carota, Ravelry as Carota 2, the number 2. And of course, I do have a studio page on Facebook, but it's kind of dormant. I also have a long-standing blog, which I've had since 04, that mostly documents my mixed media art quilts. And it's, like I said, it's been dormant for the last couple of years. I upgraded with my podcast. Sometimes I put my show notes there when I'm really good. And the same for my studio page on Facebook. It just kind of mirrors what is also on my blog with the YouTube videos. So, but you can check me out there. And any of those places, I think I'm easy to get in contact with. And so, but I've been doing this little knitting and crocheting journey for a couple of years, I guess, maybe since 2014, seriously, continuously this time. I've really just recently picked up knitting and have declared 2017 the year of knitting socks. And I'll update my progress on that. Interesting. Interesting. I've been kind of bitten by the sock bug by watching so many other podcasts. And I tell you, I am amazed at how many first-time sock knitters I've connected with on Instagram. A lot of us are knitting our first pair of socks. So some have even finished, but I'm not one of those. But anyway, I'm just going to kind of jump right in. I think I've kind of told you where I can be found and reached. I'm going to start first with my upcoming projects and acquisitions. Karen, you said you weren't going to have any acquisitions in January. Technically, I don't count these. Maybe one or two, but not. And you'll see, it'll explain. It's associated with my upcoming projects, three of which are commissions. So I don't really count them because it's not for me, per se, right? Or any gifted knitting that I happen to be doing. It's for friends. And I think I mentioned it a little bit in my last episode. So let me just kind of jump right into it. The first thing that I am, and I'm sitting at my table and the things are spread around me. Oh, wait. You know, last time I kind of reviewed my last video and I thought, I guess I should have introduced my grandparents. Okay, these are my maternal grandparents. I did not know my grandmother. Her name is Florida. And my grandfather passed away when I was 5 or 6. And his name is Mordecai. Affectionately known as Papa Mott. And that picture was painted. One of my uncles was a career serviceman and was stationed somewhere in Asia, I'm not sure where. And he had, I think, four or five, six of these painted and gifted them to his sisters, my aunts. And this is my mother's when she went to live with my sister a year or two ago. I was gifted the portrait of my grandparents as they kind of look over my shoulder. Up above that is one of my mixed media art quilts, and I'll just kind of try to get it a little of it in there. And that is from my graffiti wall series. X marks the spot is that particular, the name of that particular one. I think that's the name of it. But anyway. Okay. So, I have another one over there, but I'll show it some other time. So, yeah, I decided to hang some of my art quilts. They're kind of around. I used to keep them rolled up and kind of would ship them out when I submitted them to when they got accepted into a show or whatever, or when I was doing an exhibit. But I decided to live with them because I've kind of taken myself off the circuit a little bit for trying to continually submit my work, especially in the last couple of years. I haven't been creating as many mixed media art quilts, and mainly because of, you know, I went through a whole full year of recovering from breast cancer, and I haven't gotten the mixed media art quilt mojo back going. It's just slow going. It's steady, but it's just very slow going. But let me go ahead and get to my knitting and crocheting and all that good stuff. One of the commissions that I have, and I need to get this wound up on my, which I'll probably do as soon as I finish this, is I'll be making a shawl with this bear yarn. It will not be dyed. And I'm going to make a very dense shawl in single stitch crochet. And it will kind of have a crescent shape, V in the back. I'm going to do some embroidery on it, hand embroidery, I think. I hope that works, what I'm seeing. This will be part of a... I'm doing this for another artist who has written, has something coming out, and she's pulling together lots of artists from the city here in Louisville for this project, and I've been asked to do this to knit or crochet a shawl. I'm actually going to crochet it, like I said, single stitch crochet. I want it very dense, and this base is 50% wool, alpaca, and silk, 100 grams, 246 yards, mulberry silk, and baby alpaca, and fine merino wool. So, like I said, I'm going to cake those up. And I have about 900, 1,000 yards total when I plan to use every bit of it for the shawl that I have in mind. So that's one. So I don't really, and this yarn actually came in December. But, so it's not a January acquisition per se. So, my next thing is, I was asked to make, or I responded that I would make someone on Facebook connection, wanted to have these made. They are crocheted sneakers, done in the Converse sneakers style, and high top slipper socks. And I bought the yarn for that. I told her I would get started, put it on my January. And the yarn is, oh, right here next to me. I bought the yarn at Joann's because I needed to have it. Oh, here it is. This is it. It's going to be done in the red. And I have already have a black, so I didn't buy a black. And there's a white somewhere. Maybe I didn't bring it up. But I have a white to go with this to create. And this looks a little burnt orange, but it's on the camera. But it's really a deep, dark red. And it's a Vanish Choice, Lion Brand's Vanish Choice, worsted weight. So, soft enough, I think, that it'll be comfortable on the feet. So, I did get that. So, again, technically, this is not for me, so I had to get it to start a project. And then, for someone else, okay, who requested it. So, I needed to have that. The other thing that I did get, and I guess this could be where I broke my rule of no acquisitions, but my daughter was with me when I went to Joann's, and you know how they have these on the racks by the yarn, these little free patterns, and she loved this, and I would love to make it for her. And it is a knitted pattern. And I got the actual yarns that they use here. She wanted them. So I did get enough yarns, again, in Lion Brand Vanish Choice, to make that. It is called Chatworth's Cable Poncho. And one reason I was eager to go ahead and get it is because I've never made cables. And I was, I want to make cables with this. But I'm not going to start it until I finish the commissions that I have for other people. In fact, I told her this was her Christmas present for 2017. So, hey, nothing like early. Nothing like early. So, I did get that. And then, kind of where I broke my rule is I went on and got pink yarn for hats. Wink, wink. Yep, I'm going to make two pussy hats. So I want to knit one and crochet the other. And I think I'm going to wear them. So, yep. So that's where I broke my rule. Between that and the other thing, I went on because this is the year of socks. And I'll talk about that when I get to my works in progress. But I wanted to do magic loop and two at a time. And I didn't have small enough knitting needles and long enough cables on this size to start those. So I did get a higher sharp. This is a 40 inch. Oh, 3.75. What was I thinking? Why did I get a 3.75? Maybe I meant to get 2.75. Okay, well, anyway, I got another 40 inch that's 2.5. And I have really fat calves, so I'm thinking, I know it seems to be the 2.25 seems to be the most common size that knitters are using to knit socks, but I have really fat calves and fat ankles. So I am thinking that a 2.5. That's what I'm thinking. So anyway, I got that. So that's where those items is where is the area that I broke my verdict. Or commandment that I would not have any acquisitions for the month of January. The other acquisition was a wonderful, wonderful gift. Yay! Which I was not expecting, but appreciate so much. I received this project bag from Nadira Tani as a thank you gift, and it is just perfect for socks. just perfect for socks. And this reminds me of what my grandmother would have called a calico. That she may have used in a quilt. It has that nostalgic feel to it. And I really love it. I really love it. Very well made bag, Nadiratani. So I thank you. I thank you. Thank you. And she also included a lovely note. And two pieces of African fabric, which I thought, of course I have African fabric in my fabric stash already. And I have not a large fabric stash, but for me it's pretty large. And I thought, I'm gonna delve into making my own project bags. Is she trying to tempt me? It's working. So I may do that. I appreciate that very, very, very much. So thank you, Nadiratani. She has a podcast, and it is called, is it Nadiratani Makes? And that is spelled N-A-R-D-I-R-A. T-A-N-I, I think, Nadiratani. So you may want to check her out, see if you can find her. I love her vibe. I love her vibe, and I am inspired by so many young people who are doing this podcast thing and knitting. And I'm inspired even by older people who are knitting. I just dig the knitting podcast and the crochet podcast and the yarn head podcast. So anyway, thank you very much again, Nadiratani. I do appreciate that. Let me see. What else? Yep, I talked about let me go on to works in progress. And I don't know whether I need to call this a mofo for mostly finished object. But I do have a mostly finished object. I just need to block it and attach some pockets. It's my granddaughter's sweater. I want to start with that. And these are the pockets that I need to attach. I think I'm going to block them first and then attach them. So, and I didn't think I was going to really care for this sweater done in this Karen Cakes. But it is kind of wild, and I like it. This is the only part. You see that seam? This is the front of the sweater. And I redid it twice. And I said, I'm not going to do it again. I just have to live with it, or she has to live with it. But I couldn't figure out how to keep the seam straight. It was crocheted. This is a paid pattern, so I hope I'm not giving anything away. But it was crocheted onto the body and then crocheted down. And I may just tag the, message the designer and asked her what I did wrong. Now on this arm, the curve, the seam, is on the back side. Okay, so, and you can see it, I can see it, I don't know, it looks pretty plain to me. I don't know if when I block it, it'll ease out, but I really doubt it. This is, I think, 80% acrylic and 20% wool, so I think it's there, but I do like it, she likes it, she does say it's itchy. But it's more of the designer calls it a coatigan, kind of a cross between a coat and a cardigan. And this is where I need to find some buttons. This is where my buttons will go. Actually, this is my buttonholes. So I need to find some buttons on it. And I'm not, I wasn't going to make a, it called for a belt, but I don't think I'm going to do the belt. So it's kind of wild, but I don't think I'm a real big fan of the carrot cakes. It's okay, but I'm not a huge fan I don't like the way the colors are so jarred next to each other. It's not a gradual transition, which I would have preferred, from one color to the next. So, but I did. I want to show it one more time. Did I show the back? Yeah. Yep. So, like I said, she's happy. I'm happy. I'm happy it's done. Now, my work's in progress. Socks. I started out, this is a pattern from the Knitter's Book of Socks, and it's with worsted weight, and done on a 2.75 DPNs here, wood, they're wood, or rainbow wood, or knit, they're Knit Picks, or Knit Pro. I was able to pick this up fairly well, but I do find them fiddly. These are 5-inch. I don't know if I should have tried a 6-inch or longer, but I just don't like the way that I can feel the points in my hands and palm of my hands and while I'm knitting. I just found it fiddly. I found it very, very fiddly. I don't know that I would finish a sock. I don't know that I would become a sock lover if I had to use DPNs to do it. However, a good friend of mine, Juanita, says she loves them. It's her favorite way to knit socks. So, and what I'm learning is everybody teaches own. You know, everybody finds their own groove, you know. And that's a good thing. But DPNs, I don't think. In fact, I don't know that I'm even going to finish this. I've kept it on the needles just in case. Now, the next thing I tried was my 9-inch circs. And these are Chiagu. And I love these. And I can just go. I've made, you know, it looks janked up. You know, I'll be the first to admit, you know, there are sections where I should have knitted or purled. I purled where I should have knitted. And but overall, I like using these 9-inch circs. And I think these are done on a 2.5, I believe. But I love it. I love it. But the question that I have that I could not figure out, this is the way I knit. I knit and this cuff is facing me. It's up like this, you know, when I'm knitting. So this is the bottom. This is facing down. And of course I could turn it this way. I could. But someone said, Natalie from Knitting with Horses podcast, we were chatting on Instagram for a bit, and she said that the outside should, when you're using circulars, the outside should show. But that's the inside. So for the outside to show, it has to be up, right? And I guess, I mean, I'm still knitting. But I thought, as this gets longer and longer, I mean, I still am there. You know, it's still kind of close and intimate with me. But I just wondered if this kind of gets in the way with it being up. But, and this pattern is a free one that I found off of Ravelry. And it is what? It is what? I don't know what it is. But you can go, the notes are on my project page, though. They are there. So, I decided I wasn't going to pay for a sock pattern now, especially since I bought the book. I still want to work through the book. I do. And I'll finish this. Now, whether or not... All right. Sorry about that. Whether or not I make a second one of these to actually wear, I don't even know if it's going to fit me for one thing. Remains to be seen. But I will finish this. I'll come closer to finishing this. However, in February, it can't be my priority. That's the only thing I'm kind of bummed about. But, but I have this idea that I'm going to have a wall of framed socks. I want about 10 of them. And they're only one socks, each different. And I want to put them in my bedroom. Okay, I mean, it sounds kind of corny, but I can see it, you know. I can see it. And I wouldn't actually knit a second one until I really knitted a first one that I thought really was worthy of wearing. And who knows, maybe this one will look better once I block it, but I don't know. I don't know. And this is that Patton's Croix FX sock yarn. I don't know what the other one I think is called is a Ella Ray worsted yarn. So those are my two works in progress. And I don't know. I'm going to try the magic loop. I'm going to try the toe up. And I'm going to try the two at a time. And see, between all of those, I'm going to kind of see which is my vibe. I've seen this other thing on Ravelry where you knit a long tube. I think it's called the Afterthought Everything Sock. You knit this long tube, which are two ends. It's like you have tops of two socks. Then I guess you, is it called steak or steak? Anyway, you cut them and insert your heel and toe and finish off the toes. I don't know. That seems scary. But I think it's a neat way to approach sock making. Oh, and I'm also going to do a sock on a loom. Yeah, so all of those are on my to-do list, and I probably will not return to it until first part of March. But I'm going to kind of work dabble on this one every now and then in February. But I do like the 9-inch shirts so far. So I'm going to get started on my commissions as soon as I sign off. And so I'll see you in a couple of weeks. So take care of yourself and be good to yourself and others. And peace.